Hi, I'm Marius, and in this tutorial, I will show you how easy it is to configure the safeRS system using the safeRS Designer software. Today, we will set up a system consisting of two scanners and one manual reset button. This is a typical application for access detection, where the worker can manually reset the system. Before we can start, we need to download and install the latest software version of the safeRS Designer and the USB driver for the safeRS on sig.com. After doing so, we can connect the safeRS controller via USB to our computer and start the safeRS Designer. The dashboard opens up and gives us an overview of the system status and the configured in and outputs. On top of the screen, there are different tabs of the software. Currently, we are in the dashboard. In the tab Configuration, we can configure the system how we need it. Validation gives us the possibility to check if the system works as we want it to work. The Maintenance tab is for regular checks of the system. Settings is for further system and sensor settings. On the upper right side of the screen, you can see the Login button. In order to begin the configuration process, you need to log into the controller first. Since we have a factory new system here, we need to create a password. Then we can log in and start with the configuration. Today, we want to set up a system with two radar sensors and a manual reset button. To start the configuration, we click on the Configuration tab. Per default, one sensor is already predefined in the configuration. We can add additional radar sensors by clicking on the Add Sensor button. In our case, we add one more sensor. Now, we can individually change the settings of each sensor by selecting them with a left mouse click. On the right-hand side, we can adjust, for example, the lengths of the protective fields and warning fields. And here, you can change the opening angle of each radar sensor as well. For our setup, we configure a warning field of 50 cm, a protective field of 1 meter, and select the small opening angle of 50 degree horizontal and 15 degree vertical. Now that we have configured the sensor settings in the software, we want to transfer the configuration to the physical sensors. But first, we have to link the physical sensors to the safeRS controller. Therefore, we assign ID nodes to each safeRS sensor. ID nodes are the identification of the sensors for the controller and need to be unique for each sensor in one system. The assignment of IDs can be done in the Settings tab in the Sensor ID Nodes window. First, we need to reset the ID nodes in the software. Then, we have to physically connect the first sensor of the chain to the controller and assign the first ID. After that, we physically connect the second sensor to the first as a daisy chain and assign the second ID. Now, the controller knows that there are two sensors connected to it. In the next step, we will add the manual reset button to our configuration. This can be done in the Digital Input-Output tab. We have three inputs available. In the drop-down menu of the first input, we simply select Restart Signal. After that, we change the restart timeout to 0 seconds in the Sensor tab of the settings, so that we can immediately restart the system when the protective field is free again. Whenever an input is used, as in our case the reset button, the SNS input has to be connected to plus 24 volts. This is how the connection of the restart button and the SNS input is done. To finish the configuration, we now need to save it to the controller. This is done by the Apply Changes button in the top right of the software. Now, the configuration is stored permanently to the controller. That's all you gotta do to configure the safeRS system. Thanks for watching this tutorial.